One day in 1881, the tombstone epitaph, a booming newspaper in a booming silver mining town, screamed out the headlines about a gunfight at the OK Corral right downtown. The headlines read, "Murder in the streets of Tombstone." Well, that wasn't such hot news, but more stark and spine-chilling than that was a sight on the boardwalk in front of the epitaph building. Neatly laid out in beautiful caskets were the bodies of Tom McLowry, Frank McLowry, and young Billy Clanton, 28 years old. A witness at the trial later said that he saw Doc Holliday blast away with a nickel-plated pistol, and Billy Clanton screamed, "Don't shoot me, I don't want to fight." Today there's no more silver mining in Tombstone, but up there on Boot Hill, you can see where the graves of the men are. The ones who fought over or because of that big silver strike that created Tombstone.
Here lies Les Moore, four slugs from a 44, no less, no more. Out in Arizona, just south of Tucson, where tumbleweeds tumble in search of a home, there's a town they call Tombstone, where the brave never cry. They live by a six gun, by a six gun they die. It's been a long time now since the town was a boom. The jailhouse is empty, so's the palace saloon. Just one look will tell you that this town was real. A secluded old dirt road leads up to Boot Hill. Walk up to the fence there and look at the view. That's where they were hanging, 1882. It's easy to see where the brave men have died. Rope marks on the old tree are now petrified. At night when the moon shines so far away, it gets mighty lonesome looking down on their graves. There lies Billy Clanton, never wanted to kill, but he's there with the guilty way up on Boot Hill.